think about a pig farm, we're typically going to have our breeding gestation facility. That might be one room or multiple rooms or barns, where the pigs stay. And then usually at about 110 days of gestation, maybe 111, after being mated, they will move to the farrowing room. The idea is to get them in the farrowing room 4 to 5 days before they have babies. So the farrowing room, essentially nearly all of our farms can find sows in farrowing crates. And in this case, it's largely done to save baby pigs. So we think about our sows, they're gonna be 350 to 550 pounds. And our baby pigs when they're born are gonna be 2 or 3 pounds. And she's gonna have 10 or 15 of them. And so as they're running around and she's standing up and laying down, if we can prevent her from laying on them, that will save baby pigs. So our farrowing room has, for the most part, we'll have a farrowing crate, similar dimension to the gestation stall, where the sow can stand up and lay down comfortably. She has access to feed and water. And then in our facility, we have a mix of flooring. Typically the sow is gonna lay on a metal floor because it feels cooler. And the body temperature of a pig in while she's nursing, as with any mammals, goes up. The heat associated with milk production raises the body temperature. She wants to be cool. The farrowing room is the hardest facility to manage from a thermal standpoint because we have a large sow who wants the room to be 60 degrees and we have baby pigs who want it to be 90 degrees. And they're all in the same space. So we try to create a room that's reasonably close to 60 degrees, probably closer to 70. And then we create zones within that room for the baby pigs. So we'll use one or both of the main options would be heat bulbs in heat lamps, and those create a little radiant heat zone underneath that lamp to keep the baby pigs warm. Or we can use a heated mat. So it's a plastic pad with heater coils in it that's plugged in, and then that would heat them from the bottom up. A lot of farms will choose one or the other of those heating components, or they may use both. And here we'll often use both, and we will combine them such that when the sow is getting ready to farrow, we'll have the heat mats and the lamps on at the same time. And then by the time the pigs are 2 or 3 days old, they don't need the heat quite as much, and they've figured out that the mat is warm, and we can take the lamps away. So typically the sows, as I mentioned, will come to the farrowing room at about 110 or 111 days of pregnancy, and they will have their babies usually at about 115 or 116 days. Those piglets then, they get their colostrum from their mother. If we have a great imbalance in litter size, if we have a litter of 5 and a litter of 20, we may do some fostering of baby pigs once the colostrum is consumed. The colostrum is very important for piglet health. Those pigs, the baby pigs, will have access to milk and water, and in some farms we will also provide additional creep feed. For the most part, the pigs will grow from that kind of 3 pound birth weight to a 15 pound weaning weight by the time they're 21 days old. And so in the United States today, the average weaning age is about 21 days. So at that age, those pigs will be weaned. They'll be taken away from their mothers. The mothers will go back to the breeding gestation room. We'll initiate detection of estrus again, and we intend for those sows to be mated again within a week after weaning. The baby pigs then go to a nursery.